بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
A presentation of Quran Sunnah educational programs. Visit us online at www.qsep.com.
This fatwa was put on the internet and Sheikh Ghunayman was told about it and he said, this is not what I said. And then he mentioned what he said. And the content of what he said is that Ash'ariyya are from Ahl Sunnah if you mean by Ahl Sunnah to be what is opposite to Shias, because this is what Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah has said also. He said the concept Ahl Sunnah has two meanings. One meaning is Ahl Sunnah versus Shias, and therefore the Ash'aris and the Mu'tazilas are from Ahl Sunnah in this meaning. But if you say Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, then there is only one Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, and that is Ahlul Hadith and the Salafis. And the rest of the groups are not from Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Ash'ariyya, Maturidiyya, whoever they might be. And what Shaykh al-Ghunayman meant is that if there is a situation where the Ash'aris are the closest to Ahl Sunnah in that place, yani in that place you don't have Ahlul Hadith or Ahlul Sunnah, the pure ones, but you have Ash'aris, you have Mu'tazilas, you have Shias, you have Zaydis, you have this, you have that. So the Ash'aris here, as also Shaykh al-Islam said, they are Ahl Sunnah. You see, in comparison to the rest, they are Ahl Sunnah. Why? Because they are the closest to Ahl Sunnah. You see? Also, sometimes it might be a necessity to do something together with Ash'aris against the enemies of Allah, against the Kafirs, against the enemies of Allah. Whether it is a jihad, fighting, like the people did, for example, with Salahuddin. Salahuddin was Ash'ari. And he was not only an Ash'ari, he was spreading Ash'ariyya. And he was very proud of it. And despite that, when he fought the Crusaders, no Muslim said, we don't join hands with Ash'aris against the Crusaders. And when he fought the so-called Fatimids, no one said, we don't join hands with Salah al-Din because he's Ash'ari. No, they all joined hands, you see. Why? Because Ash'aris have a lot in common with Ahl Sunnah. Still, they have a lot in common with them. This is what the answer of Sheikh Abdullah al-Ghunayman was. And the other ones who signed this kind of يعني بيان were themselves Ash'aris. They were themselves Ash'aris. So don't be fooled by their statement. They made up the statement. And they included Sheikh al-Ghunayman with them without him knowing of their bayan and statement until it was out. And they were Ash'aris, and you expect them to say that. Then the names that they mentioned in the bayan, that Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani was Ash'ari, and al-Mizzi was Ash'ari, and this was Ash'ari, and that, Ibn al-Salah, and things like that. Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani was not Ash'ari. Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani refuted the Ash'ariyya in Fathul Bari in many, many places in their fundamentals, in the issue of the first duty, which is Tawheed, he replied on them, because the first duty with the Ash'aris is to look into the universe, you see. And in Hadith al-Ahad, he replied on them. He replied on the Ash'aris in Hadith al-Ahad, and he replied on them in many other places. And he called them by names. Similarly, Nawawi, he replied on Asha'ira in many places, and he called them by names. Similarly, Ibn al-Jawzi, he replied on Ash'ari, you know. So those people are not Ash'aris. They might have been affected by some Ash'ari sheikhs in one aspect, like names and attributes of Allah, but this doesn't make them Ash'aris, because Ash'ariyah is not only the deviation in the issue of names and attributes of Allah. It's a deviation in Qadr, a deviation in Iman, a deviation in many other things, you see. Nah. And those scholars like Ibn Hajar, Nawawi, and those, they are scholars of Hadith. They respect the Hadith. They have spent their life in serving the Hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, you see. So they are scholars of Hadith, Ahl Sunnah. When Ash'aris are scholars of Kalam, they are called scholars of Talk, Kalam. And they call themselves that, and they are proud of that. And they have a general fundamental which says, when the logic is against the verse or against the Hadith, then we give priority to the logic. So this shows how deviant they are, actually. And this is, how could they be Ahl-Sunnah when they are like this? Plus the fact that Sheikh Abdullah Al-Ghuniman knows that those Ash'aris nowadays are mostly also Quburis and Sufis. Almost most of the scholars of Ash'aris are Quburis,